calculate GCD of two numbers. So let's start by creating a new project. We can say GCD or HCF, highest common factor. Save it, save the project, save the main file. Okay, let's start by using namespace std. Okay, as usual, we first will try to understand what's the problem means and what is meant by GCD, greatest common divisor. Here are the three words that are self-explanatory. Greatest common divisor, a number among the dividers of these given numbers that is the largest one. So let's start by taking an example. If we say that we have two numbers, let's suppose first number is 12. What are the dividers? Which will the dividers of these two numbers? We are not still talking about the greatest common. So that when we will say common, when we have an other dividers list of an other number. Now only we will be talking about dividers. Which will the dividers 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 and 12 itself, etc. These are the dividers of 12. Now we will say that if we have any other number, that let's say 8, which will the dividers of 8, these will be the 1, 2 and 4 and 8. Only these are the four dividers of 8. Here is the solution exist among these two lines. These are the dividers of first number, these are the dividers of second number. Now we will have to find the common. We have get the dividers. These are the three step challenge. First of all, we will have to find the dividers. Then we will have to find the common. Then in last, we will have to find greatest. This is the actual problem's solution in three steps: dividers, common and greatest, in reverse order. We have get dividers. Now we were getting commons. Commons are 1 is in 12's divider, 1 is in 8's divider, 2 is in 12's divider, 2 is in 8's divider, and 3 not in 8's divider, 4 is in 12's divider list, and 4 is also in 8's divider list. Now second step we have clearly done, and now in last step we will get greatest. The greatest among which dividers we have find, the list is 1 including 2 including 3. These are the common dividers, and these are the dividers. First step we have done, and this is the second step, and the last step is the greatest among these is 4. We can clearly see here this is the 4, so that we can say that HCF, highest common factor, or GCD of 4, 8 and 8 and 12 is equivalent to 4. Here the problem's solution exists in the logical way. This is the clear solution of GCD. Now we are going to put this problem solution. As usual, we are taking num1, num2, and we can also take the third variable g, or we can say it GCD, ICF, etc. So let's start by taking input into these two numbers. Writing here code, enter first number, cin num1, similar way cout, enter second number, and we can say this one is getting in num2. Okay, now we will have to start the processing or computation of this GCD from these two numbers. So start from the simple iteration. For int I, counter variable, is equivalent to 1, because 1 is also including in all dividers. from 1, I is less than or equivalent to. Where is the termination? Termination condition is a logical compound condition where I is less than or equivalent to num 1, num 1 and I is less than equivalent to num 2. Here we will increment counter variable by 1. This is the iterative statement. We will start from 1. We will go up to the both number will goes to tends to its end, means up to the numbers. In iteration we will find if num 1 modulus I is equivalent to 0 and num 2 modulus I is equivalent to 0, means ke I is dividing both of these two numbers completely by I is completely dividing these two numbers, then what we will have to get, this will give us GCD. GCD, as we say earlier, GCD is the number that is dividing the given two numbers completely and greatest. This first step will get the number that is getting divide two numbers, two given numbers. Okay, at the end of this iteration we will print GCD is equivalent to, here is the variable that is containing the GCD. Okay, let's try to compile this code. Compiling this compiled successfully, running this code. Now we will consider the example that we have taken in the source code. This is clearly saying that the GCD of these two numbers, these which numbers are 8 and 12 of the given numbers, is 4. Now we can demonstrate the same example code for any other numbers. If we say that one number is 17 and other is 12, then the greatest common divisor will 1, because no other divisor of these two numbers, two given numbers, is common rather than 1. Similar way, we can also see another example to clearly elaborate this GCD mechanism. We can say that one is 8 and other is 16, then the greatest common divisor will be the 8, because 16's divisor are 1, 2, 3, 4, 8 itself, and the 8's divisor are 1, 2, 4, 8 itself. The greatest common will be the 8. This is a procedure by which we can take greatest common divisor of two numbers among. Method and technique is simple, as we discussed earlier in the source code in the form of comment. Three numbers are required, variables are required. Here we get input for these required variables. Here we complete the iteration starting from the 1, because 1 is also included in the dividers, up to the num 1 and num 2. Here is the focus point, and num 1 and num 2. Okay, then if any one of I coming iterative variable is completely dividing both of the given variables dividers, here is the solution. It may be in first iteration 1, but iteration will go tends to the ending of these two numbers, both two numbers. Then the second GCD over iteration will say that this is 2, not this is the 2, because there are more multipliers, dividers of these two numbers. Then third or fourth iteration will say this is the 4. When this will say this is the 4, the iteration will complete and the given GCD will exist and resides in GCD variable. Okay.